Welcome to a video on the limit comparison test for the convergence of an infinite series. We need to be careful not to confuse this with the comparison or direct comparison test. This is the limit comparison test. So the limit comparison test states that we have two infinite series that both have positive terms, and the limit of the quotient of a sub n and b sub n equals L, where L is finite and positive, then both series converge or diverge. So the idea behind this test is, if we let A sub n be the given series, and it resembles B sub n, and we know B sub n either converges or diverges, then if the limit of the quotient equals L, which is finite and positive, we can use that to determine whether A sub n also converges or diverges. So the limit comparison test can be helpful when maybe we can't apply the direct comparison test. Let's go and take a look at some examples. This series here should remind us of the infinite series of 3 divided by 4 to the power of n. Notice as n increases, we multiply the denominator by additional factors of 4, which is the same as multiplying by 1/4 each time. So this is a geometric series where r is equal to 1/4 and therefore converges by the geometric series test. So r is equal to 1/4, which is less than 1, and therefore converges. So now we can use the limit comparison test to find the limit of this quotient and see if L is positive and finite. And if it is, we know that the given series is also convergent. So now we'll take the limit as n approaches infinity of a sub n divided by b sub n. Now it doesn't matter which of these formulas we let equal a sub n and b sub n. Let's go ahead and let this equal a sub n. So 3 divided by 4 to the power of n, all divided by b sub n, which will let equal the given formula of 3 divided by 4 to the power of n minus 3. Let's go ahead and convert this to a multiplication problem. So we'll have 3 divided by 4 to the power of n times the reciprocal of this. So we'll have 4 power of n minus 3 divided by 3. Well, here the 3 simplify out. We're left with the limit as n approaches infinity of 4 to the n minus 3 divided by 4 to the n. Now since we're dividing by one term, we can break this up into two different fractions. So 4 to the n divided by 4 to the n minus 3 divided by 4 to the n. Well, this is going to equal 1. And as n increases, our denominator increases without bound. This will approach 0, so 1 minus 0 would equal 1. Since the value of this limit is positive and finite, by the limit comparison test, the given series also converges. Let's go and take a look at another example. Here we have the summation of 5 divided by the square root of n squared minus 1. So if we ignore this minus 1, we'd have the square root of n squared, which is equal to n. So this series resembles the harmonic series of 1 divided by n, which we know diverges by the p-series test. With p equal to 1, which is less than or equal to 1. So since the series that it resembles diverges, if we take the limit of this quotient, where L is a finite positive number, it will also show that the given series diverges. Let's go ahead and give it a try. We're going to have the limit as n approaches infinity of the quotient of a sub n divided by b sub n. And again, it doesn't matter which of these formulas we let equal a sub n or b sub n. If For this problem, I'm going to go ahead and let a sub n equal 5 divided by the square root of n squared minus 1. Divided by b sub n, which is 1 divided by n. So now we'll rewrite this as a product of two fractions. So we'll have the limit as n approaches infinity of 5 divided by the square root of n squared minus 1 times the reciprocal of 1 over n, which is n divided by 1. Nothing simplifies here, so we'll go ahead and just multiply across the top and the bottom. So we'll have 5n in the numerator divided by the square root of n squared minus 1. Remember, the technique to help us evaluate this limit would be to divide by the highest power of n in the denominator. Well, we do have an n squared in the denominator, but it's underneath the square root. And the square root of n squared is equal to n. So we're going to divide the numerator by n and divide the denominator by the square root of n squared. So our numerator will be 5n divided by n. And for the denominator, we're going to have n squared divided by n squared. Both of these are underneath the square root, minus 1 divided by n squared. Well, this will give us a 5 in the numerator, and we'll have the square root of 1 minus 1 over n squared. So as n approaches infinity, we'll have 5 over the square root of 1, which is equal to 5. Well, this limit is positive and finite, so by the limit comparison test, the given series also diverges. I think we have time for one more. We'll take a look at the formula for this series. There's a lot going on here, but if we consider just the highest powers of n in the numerator and denominator, we'd have n to the fourth and then n to the sixth in the denominator. So if we take n to the fourth over n to the sixth and simplify it, we're going to have 1 over n squared. So we're going to say that this series resembles the series generated by the summation of 1 divided by n squared. And this series converges by the p-series test with p equal to 2. Which is greater than 1. So now if we take the limit of this quotient, and it's positive and finite, since this series converges, we can show that the given series converges. Let's go ahead and give it a try. We'll have the limit as n approaches infinity of a sub n divided by b sub n. Let's go ahead and let this formula equal a sub n. So we'll have n to the fourth plus 2n squared plus 1 divided by 6n to the sixth plus 4n to the fourth. Now instead of dividing by 1 over n squared, let's go ahead and multiply by the reciprocal, which would be n squared over 1. Now we'll multiply the numerator by n squared. So we'll have n to the sixth plus 2n to the fourth plus n squared all over 6n to the sixth plus 4n to the fourth. Instead of dividing each term by n to the sixth now, remember for limits at infinity, if the degree of the numerator and denominator are the same, then the limit will equal the ratio of the leading coefficients. So this limit will be equal to 1/6, which again is positive and finite. So since this series converges, so does the given series by the limit comparison test. That'll do it for the limit comparison test. I hope you found this video helpful.